My name is Rit Premnath. I'm an artist, the editor of a publication called Shifter, and I'm assistant professor of fine arts at Parsons. I wanted to talk about a project that's really kind of at its inception, the new, the new issue of Shifter, which I haven't quite started working on yet, or have only sort of begun, but I wanted to contextualize that with three older issues. I call them issues because Shifter is considered a magazine, an artist magazine, but each issue takes a different form, and takes a different amount of time. The last three issues really came out as a result of a certain kind of thinking around my relation to education. As an artist who had begun teaching maybe 5-6 years ago, I started to wonder about what it meant to be a teacher, what it meant to teach art, whether one could do that, and also what it meant to teach at all. I started to think about Bernard Shaw's quip, he who can does, he who cannot teaches, and started to worry about my career choice. And my very close friend and painter in Chicago, Matthew Metzger, who had started co-editing Shifter with, had also started teaching. And so we thought we would funnel our worries into an issue of Shifter. After all, we had a lot of friends who also taught. And so we would invite them to have conversations with other people, other artists who they had shared a teaching relationship with, either as students or as teachers, but who now they consider to be colleagues, artists in the world, to talk about this relationship. What does this teacher-student relationship mean? How does that intimacy and power extend into something beyond that teaching relationship and extend out into the world? And so Shifter's 20th issue was one way for us, what we can not, so this kind of not around what it means to do, whether teaching is a kind of doing in the same way that art making is a kind of doing, became a way for us to explore this this problem. Sorry, I'm having some slide issues, so we can just pretend like it's not a problem. But, and this was the first kind of moment for this exploration, and there were some great participants in this project, Marietica Portich, Adlita Husni Bey, who does a lot of art around education, A.K. Burns, who co-runs Wage and is a friend, and people who have very active art practices but are very engaged in pedagogy, and I feel that it was a fruitful way for me to engage. And Shifter's 21st issue, titled Other Spaces, started to kind of bring me into this other mode of thinking around this question of what Foucault's heterotopia might look like in reconsidering educational practices and institutions outside of academia or beside academia. I started to read Fred Moten's Undercommons and started to rethink think about what it might mean for me to think about education outside of the academy or underneath the academy. And so Other Spaces was an issue of Shifter that kind of became a kind of research project, really, inviting, again, artists from around the world, friends, to think through these questions with me. But this was also an issue that I think was a kind of turning point for me, because I'd started to realize that as this publication that I've been working on for a decade at this point, the parts of publication making that were most enjoyable to me were the editorial parts of it. I enjoyed actually getting submissions and working on them with people it was this kind of moment of very focused and engaged collaboration. And I didn't really enjoy the two other parts, which is asking for submissions and then trying to distribute the publication. And I realized that most of my time spent doing Shifter was the two things that I hated doing. And this editorial part had become this very sort of short part in the middle of publication making. And so this, the 22nd issue of Shifter became a project for me to try and address this, to try and figure out how to change my editorial practice to better reflect what I wanted Shifter to be. And so I thought, let me not think about what this publication is going, or how this publication is going to come about. I'm going to think about a project that I want to do, and then we'll figure out how it turns into a publication later. And so I co-edited this issue with Avi Alpert, and what we decided to do was have a bi-weekly discussion group where we would invite two people to present a keyword, circulate some readings that people may or may not read, and have a conversation. And this was hosted at the New School. And over the course of, and there's several participants, the core participants, Amanda, Lindsay, who were part of this discussion group. And the thing that I really enjoyed about this was that it extended the editorial or collaborative aspect of this publication into a year and a half of biweekly meetings. It was also run alongside my teaching. So this was in Parsons. I was using the infrastructure of the new school. But it was extracurricular. So I had current students, I had alumni and friends, artists, others who would come regularly to these discussions, and so I think it became a kind of extracurricular pedagogical experiment. And the way the publication came to be was a Google Doc that was shared amongst the people who came to these discussions. And so whoever came would be added to the Google Doc. They could add questions, thoughts, reflections. We only asked that they not write long things, that they need to be either fragments or questions. The reason for this was that I didn't want to document the event at all, but thought of the publication as being a kind of opening that potentially someone who picked it up later could begin a conversation rather than find a definition. And that's something too that has become more and more interesting to me, how to focus on the thing at hand, the conversation at hand, and not be focused on documenting it and figuring out what to do with the documentation. How to reduce the amount of noise in a way and find as little as possible to share at the end. And so it's out of this sort of thinking that I've come to this new project, which is incredibly undercooked at this moment. I have a title for it, Engagements in Learning Through Unlearning. It was something that came to me from reading, Gayatri Spivak, came out of, I'll end with just reading this set of prompts maybe. A desire to do something like the Dictionary of the Possible, but rather than having artists and critics and people who are comfortable speaking in this manner, inviting people who I wouldn't normally invite, but who I'm interested in hearing from. The first discussant in this series was, the first convener of the series was Musaker Butt, who's the guard who sits at 25 East 13th Street, and who I see every day, pretty much. And so with that in mind, I'll just read out these prompts, and maybe this will lead to some discussion over food. Engagements in learning through unlearning. Following on our previous discussion-based project, The Dictionary of the Possible, Shifter invites you to join in a new kind of conversation. With the dictionary, we work to unpack the many meanings of the words we share. With our new series, Unlearning, we invite you to take a closer look at the worlds we share. The aim will be for all of us to unlearn our assumptions and prejudices about each other in a time when the urgency for new solidarities has never been greater. To this end, unlearning will ask us to abandon our default ways of speaking and thinking and embrace new ways of communicating that draw out each person's innate capacity for both practice and reflection. This will be a new experiment for all of us, and here are some fluid guidelines that we offer as a point of departure. Each session is about a labor of love. Professional amateurism should be embraced. Our time is ours, and we can learn anew how to use it. Economic value is not a sufficient logic for how we spend our time. Rather than describe, we will enact. More than speaking, we will look and listen. Suggestions will take precedence over directions. The process matters more than the outcome. The process matters most when we are engaged. We have no time for cynicism and postures of solemnity. Sincerity, humility, and openness are our basic values.